Greetings and welcome to Spiritual Magic Journey. Guys, today I wanted to talk with you about your altar. What is an altar? I also have an altar blessing for you guys that are just now setting up your altars, or you have set up one and you want to do your blessing with it. First, let's talk about what is an altar and how do we use these altars. That is going to depend on what you're using it for. It's going to mean different things for different people. Me personally, I'm giving you all my experience here and all my personal, wisdom and advice. I've got three. I've got one here that I use specifically here for this channel that I show you guys spells and stuff like that. I've also got an ancestral altar, and that's the, for all my ancestors that have passed over. I wanted to make one of those altars, so I have that one, this one for this channel, and I also have my personal big one. Now you may have one. Some people, you can have as many as you want to. The big one I use mainly for myself and doing spells for others. For clients, let's just say for myself and for my clients. And of course, my ancestral altar is to pay homage and blessings to all my ancestors, spirits that have passed, and to call on them when I need, help with anything. I sit there, I meditate, and I've got it with different pictures of some of my ancestors and not only my ancestors, but some of my pets that have passed away. I have their picture there. What goes on these altars depends totally on you and what you're doing. Now, some people will set up just a place to do a spell that they need to do, and then they will discard it, tear it back down, whatever you want to call it, and they won't set up anything else till they get ready to do their next spell. My altar stay up, they're up for good. That way I can come to them anytime I get ready to do anything, or I've got a client that I'm working with to help them with a spell. What goes on them entirely depends on what you're working with and what you want to accomplish. A lot of people put, stones, crystal grids. If you're working with grid work, herbs, spices, candles, of course, if you're working with a certain deity or, some type of energy or person or spirit or something like that. Sometimes people will have statues of these deities that they work with on their altar. Some people go to these altars to meditate, to ask for guidance, to, of course, do their magic, do their spell work, and just talk to the spirits, talk to the higher, talk to the divine beings, talk to deities, communicate with them, and many, many other things. So when you're setting up your altar, whatever, how you want to do it, or if you're just doing it for a specific spell, you always want to do a blessing of that altar that you have got set up. And you really want to do it not just the first time, but you really want to do this a blessing, at least, especially if you're working at that altar all the time. You really need to do blessings at least twice a month. It depends on what kind of energy you're doing and what kind of work you're doing. But there's, I just want to show you guys a few ways that you can do the blessings, and I also have an honor blessing chant for you guys to say. So a lot of the cleansing stuff for your altars is what I use here. I've got some pieces of holy wood, and you can get these at any metaphysical shop. You can get them on eBay, anywhere. Just type in holy wood and it will come up and give you some background information on that. Of course, everybody knows about sage and cleansing. It's a good way. And this is another thing I use here is this is a cedar stick. And I've also got, where is my sweet grass? I've got let me jump over here to my other altar. Grab this piece of sweet grass. Make sure I show you these guys. This is a piece of sweet grass. Can you see it? Oh, I love the smell of sweet grass. Woo! There's my little piece. Reminds me of the powwow trail. Being at powwows as a kid, dancing, and set up selling, I could always smell this burning at everyone's booth, every vendor's booth is sweet grass. Let me put this piece back. So whatever you're going to use to do your cleansing and your altar blessing with, whether it's sweet grass, cedar stick, sage, you know, holy wood, you're going to light it. You don't have to have a feather to do the flames. I meant the smoke. You don't have to, but it's good if you do. You know, I sell these too over on Sherry's Magical Place on Bonanza. I sell a lot of stuff. You're going to light whatever you're going to use again, and you can repeat this altar blessing. From the mystic light to the fertile foundations on the shores of the waters, out of the hopes and dreams, on the wings of love, out of light and inspiration, which the inner flame kindled, with the inner flame kindled, divine spark and gleam, back to the light, for manifestation surely, swiftly fulfilled, moves the unseen by the moon, the stars and the sun, by the gods, the goddess and the ancient ones. Blessed be this altar and all here on, good for all and harming none. And you can repeat that if need be. And I'll repeat it again with some sage, with my smoke signals. Like I said, if you're doing really working continuously at your altar, you really need to cleanse it and bless it 2 or 3 times a month if you can. And just go around your altar. Can you see that? If you've got a fan, make sure you're getting it all around. From the mystic light to the fertile foundations, on the shores of the waters, out of hopes and dreams, on the wings of love, out of light and inspirations, with the inner flame kindled, divine spark and gleam, back to the light for manifestation swiftly fulfilled, moves the unseen by the moon, the stars, and the sun, by the gods and ancient ones. Blessed be this altar and all here on. Good for all and harm in none. So blessed be, this will be done. Thank you guys. Just wanted to share that with you. If you do have an altar or thinking about setting up one, or it's nice to have one. It's a good place to go meditate and talk to your spirit guides, talk to your higher self, and just communicate and become one. Integrate all your higher aspects of your higher self or your dominant guides, however you want to put that, but you know what I'm talking about. All right, guys, love each and every one of you. Hope this helps you in your journey through life. Blessings, my friend. Namaste.